Good Thursday morning to you. Hey, it's foggy out here on this Thursday. It is at least where I live here in this part of Louisiana. And I didn't anticipate the fog today. And so when the fog comes, it does affect the way you drive on the roads. You have to be extra cautious. You can't see as far normally when there's fog, obviously. And so the fog does affect. There are times in your life and my life, we're going to have foggy days where we can't really see all that's going on. We have to be extra cautious on those days. It's like with any weather pattern that comes through. Right now, in the Gulf, there is a major storm that's brewing. And so they're saying there's a great chance for some rain, some wind, some other things happening later in the week. But that's the weather forecasters giving us a heads up, if you will. Not every storm, like today, the fog that's here, no one really gave us a heads up because there's some things with weather you can't really predict. The storm in the Gulf right now that's developing, that's already hit Mexico with some heavy rains. The weather forecasters are watching that very closely. And they're giving us a heads up, and even the governor yesterday reminded us that we're of Louisiana. The governor of Louisiana reminded us yesterday that we're entering the hurricane season, and there's some things we can do. There's a list of things we can do to prepare for that season just in case. And so with this weather pattern, this weather tropical storm developing now, the forecasters are letting us know, they're giving us a heads up that, hey, there's some weather coming and it could be quite severe. Prepare for that. Not every storm in your life can you have a heads up about. There's some storms that you wake up one morning and there's a storm. There's some storms in the middle of the day. You're just going about your business, going about and doing what you do. And all of a sudden, boom, a storm pops up in your life. Or you're fixing to go to bed at night and you've had a long day. And so you're getting ready for bed and all of a sudden, boom, a storm pops up. A phone call gives you news that you did not expect. Someone comes and knocks on your door and you did not expect the news that they would bring. It's a storm. Again, on this Thursday, I just want to remind you that all storms are not forever. Even Job in the Bible, all that he went through, scholars tell us that it was not a lifetime thing that Job went through all that. But it was probably about 6 months that Job went through all those things that he went through, losing his kids and losing his health and losing everything that he owned, basically. That was about a six-month time frame in Job's life. Every storm doesn't last forever. And hey, the good news about Job's life was that the Lord was kind to him and gave him double what he lost. The Lord turned around and gave him double for everything that he lost. And you just have to know and believe the storm, whatever it is in your life, is not going to last forever. And the Lord knows right where you are in the midst of the storm. He is with you. He's with you. And so during the storm, don't turn from God, but turn to God. I know that's a simple concept, but I see people every day get in the middle of a storm, the storm of their life. And instead of turning to God, they turn away from God. And they let their faith go out the window, if you will. They just kind of abandon their faith and try to tough it out on their own. Listen, if you're in the storm today or you're in the storm next week or next month or next year, whenever the storm comes, because the storm is coming, run to the Lord. Look to the Lord. Lean on the Lord Jesus. Don't run from Him. That's not the time to abandon the ship. That's not the time to abandon God. Whenever you're in the storm, it's all part of life. Storms come. It rains on the just and it rains on the unjust. The storm will come, but during the storm, do not abandon the Lord Jesus. Don't abandon Him. Hey, He's the best insurance you could possibly have. He's the strength giver. He's the comforter. He is the protector. And he'll see you through the storm if you don't run from him, but run to him. All right. Keep that in mind, if you will. And it's a great reminder on this Thursday. Run to Jesus, not away from him during your storm, whether it's fog or whether it's a hurricane.